introduced as the centerpiece of the latest MCRN fleet modernization program, the fearsome Donnager Class Battleship stands as the largest and most sophisticated serving warship in the solar system, far outclassing any vessel in use by the United Nations and serving as the preeminent representation of Martian technological innovation and military might. At a length of 475.5 meters and a dry mass of 250,000 tons, the striking angular frame of the Donnager class maintains the sleek and efficient aesthetic that has become the hallmark of the Martian Navy. The vessel is propelled by four massive RT-10 Kaminari Epstein drives, providing the necessary thrust to accelerate the Donnager's enormous mass through combat maneuvers and interplanetary transits. The Donnager class carries a crew of 2,086, in addition to a sizable contingent of conventional marines, and most often at least one unit of power armor-equipped Force Recon marines. The Donnager class carries a huge arsenal of extremely advanced and precise weapons systems, including a pair of turreted VX-12 faux hammer ultra-heavy railguns, matched only in range and firepower by dedicated orbital gun platforms. These weapons are supported by 6 forward and 8 aft rapid reload torpedo launchers linked to shared magazines of high explosive plasma, flechette, and tactical nuclear warheads. The vessel's defense grid is comprised of 59 Narrowman Dynamics 40mm PDCs linked to the most advanced target tracking system in use by the MCRN. These cannons are able to easily screen the vessel from large barrages of all but the most sophisticated torpedoes. Finally, the Donnager class features 2 vacant hardpoints on her dorsal and ventral hull that can theoretically be used to mount 2 additional turreted VX-12 railguns. While this has been tested in fleet exercise scenarios, it has never been used in mainline service and is predicted to present a great risk of lethal thermal overload or electrical failure due to the numerous stresses of using 4 such weapons simultaneously. The initial wave of Donnager-class ships to be commissioned included 8 vessels, most of which were constructed at the MCRN shipyards on Callisto. Most of these vessels were assigned standing defensive roles around Mars itself and important holdings in the Jovian system. The first of the class, the MCRN Donnager, was placed under the command of Captain Teresa Yao and appointed flagship of the MCRN. The Donnager was assigned to lead the Martian Jupiter fleet, but was frequently dispatched on solo force projection missions, such as the pirate suppression campaign known as Operation Silent Wall. The fleet modernization program that introduced the Donnager-class battleship also included 2 other now ubiquitous warship models, both of which were specifically designed to work in tandem with the Donnager-class. The Morrigan-class patrol destroyer and Corvette-class light frigate are both regularly stored within the Donnager-class battleship's large amidships docking bays. Keeping these vessels embarked allows an MCRN fleet to conceal their true numbers from any hostile observer and to spread their forces over a larger area during reconnaissance missions or defensive patrols. The Combat Information Center of the Donnager class is housed within a sealable bunker, suspended inside a large negative space toward the ship's bow. This main structure is flanked by additional bunkers, meant to serve as redundant command centers in the event of an emergency. Prior to entering combat, the negative space these structures are housed within is sometimes evacuated of atmosphere, with each of the individual bunkers being pressure sealed. This prevents uncontrollable thrust vectors being created if the ship's hull is breached, but allows the senior officers within the control bunkers to continue performing their duties without the need for vacuum suits. Much like the far smaller Scirocco class, the Donnager class carries large onboard barracks facilities designed to house Martian marines and their equipment. Many of the vessels also carry elite MMC force recon units, equipped with Goliath-class powered armor. These units are lethal in boarding actions and allow the Donnager class to reinforce MCRN facilities or planetside holdings by deploying a garrison. In combat, ships of the Donnager class most often serve as command vessels, using their sophisticated tactical systems and advanced ranging lasers to support and coordinate a larger fleet of Martian warships. Prior to the outbreak of war with the United Nations, the MCRN most often engaged simple pirate groups and criminals, against whom the mere presence of a Donnager class ship was more than enough to inspire retreat. Even after the dawn of interplanetary war, the Donnager class remained the most advanced and powerful class of ship involved in the conflict, far outstripping the aging Truman-class dreadnoughts of the United Nations and struggling only when faced with overwhelming numbers. Designed and constructed in the Nariman Industrial District of Londres Nova, the 40mm PDCs installed on the Donnager class are the same models used on the smaller Corvette and Morrigan class vessels. The unique difference is that the Donnager's PDC grid is linked to a cutting-edge K-19 Banisher targeting system, which allows the ship's defense grid to isolate and destroy almost any incoming torpedoes with flawless accuracy, and to swiftly reorient additional batteries to focus on projectiles that threaten to penetrate the grid. When forced into close quarters combat, the ship's PDCs are also effective as direct ship-to-ship weapons, able to fire thousands of Teflon-coated tungsten rounds a minute that can completely perforate all but the largest vessels, and inflict critical damage on internal subsystems. Nariman Dynamics PDC emplacements can be retracted to protect them from impact damage, and are equipped with extensive cooling systems to allow them to maintain uninterrupted fire for extended periods without risk of thermal overload. Where many UNN ships employ large numbers of single-fire torpedo housings, the Donnager class uses inbuilt auto-loading systems to feed a variety of torpedo warheads from storage magazines to any of the ship's 14 launch tubes to be fired in quick succession. The ship carries a large supply of conventional high-explosive warheads that can be configured with variable yields for use when firing to disable. The ship also carries plasma warheads designed to melt away hull plating on contact, and flechette torpedoes, programmed to detonate into a widening cone of shrapnel moments before impact to cause widespread damage. Finally, the ship carries a small supply of tactical nuclear torpedoes, authorized for use only in the direst scenarios. The VX-12 ultra-heavy railguns carried aboard the battleships are an entirely new design, purpose-built for use aboard the Donnager class. They boast the longest range and greatest firepower of any ship-mounted railgun ever constructed, allowing the Donnager class to serve almost as an artillery platform in space combat, precisely eliminating targets from huge distances where UNN railguns cannot achieve a proper target lock. The weapons are extended on large hardpoints that provide sufficient clearance to fire off the vessel's aft while it performs deceleration burns, allowing the ship to continue pressing the attack during repositioning maneuvers. The articulation systems themselves are incredibly sturdy and able to swing through 180 degrees to acquire a target, even when the battleship is under thrust and performing complex course corrections. While the 3rd and 4th railgun hardpoints currently present serious risk of overload if used, they were incorporated into the Donnager's design as one of many attempts to future-proof the vessel, providing a feature that could fall into regular use once more advanced reactor systems and recoil dampening technologies, presently being researched by the MCRN, are finally brought into service. The same is true of the ship's docking bays, which were designed to be compatible with a number of smaller vessels not presently in use but planned to be deployed across the coming years. In anticipation of the many pirate suppression campaigns the ship would be deployed on, the Donnager class was built to carry a large maximum security brig facility, taking up multiple levels within the ship's primary hull. This area is placed close to the vessel's docking bays to allow for simple prisoner transfer, and is equipped with layers of automated security, including bulletproof pressure doors, anesthetic gas dispensers, and automated gun turrets to prevent escape attempts. While impressive, these features are almost never used, as the mere prospect of escaping an MCRN battleship and commandeering a vessel with which to flee is considered completely infeasible. Most prisoners captured during campaigns such as Operation Silent Wall were transported back to Mars aboard vessels like the Donnager and her sister ships, whereupon they were delivered to the Acheron prison facility at Olympus Mons to serve out lifelong hard labor sentences. The only vessel of the Donnager class ever to be lost in combat was the MCRN Donnager herself, when her captain was forced to order Condition Zero and activate the vessel's self-destruct system after she was ambushed and boarded by what were later confirmed to be Protogen Amun-Ra class stealth ships. Despite being unaware of the enemy's true numbers and capabilities until the last moment, the Donnager put up an impressive fight against a superior force equipped with previously unknown technology. Before being disabled and boarded, the Donnager was able to destroy 4 of the 6 vessels, and the remaining 2 were unable to escape the blast from the Donnager's self-destruction. Following the loss of the Donnager, the position of Martian flagship fell to the MCRN Icaria Planum, one of the Donnager's sister ships, which had previously been assigned to Homeworld Defense. The destruction of the Donnager claimed the lives of many of the MCRN's best officers and inspired widespread anger among the Martian armed forces, which served as one of the major contributors toward the outbreak of war with the UNN, precisely the outcome the Protogen Corporation had hoped for. The construction and commissioning of a Donnager-class vessel is staggeringly expensive and resource-intensive, with the initial wave of 8 ships consuming a vast portion of the Martian defense budget. For this reason, very few ships of the class have been assembled since, but a slow and steady construction plan for additional vessels remains active, with Martian shipwrights anticipating a service life of many decades for the class. The Donnager-class battleship stands as the greatest expression of Martian technological prowess and naval power, projecting the authority and influence of the Martian Republic through presence alone, and standing as one of the most fearsome war machines ever designed. Ships like the MCRN Donnager and her compatriots are representative of the huge advances made by Mars in the century since their secession from Earth, and the powerful advantages they have secured over the decrepit United Nations Navy. Though UNN numbers remain superior, it can no longer be denied which nation has secured technological superiority, as it is now an almost universally accepted fact that the solar system's fiercest warships bear the black and orange markings of the Martian Congressional Republic Navy.